I'm Grishma and you are watching my channel G tutorial. This is my first video on AI ADC exam. Here I am going to discuss about calculus of complex functions from math section of AI ADC exam. I will be uploading more math related videos for AI ADC exam going forward. This is my first topic and I have chosen this topic because this is one of the important topics for AI ADC exam which will get you at least 2 to 3 questions. If you are watching my video for the first time, please subscribe my channel for getting more videos related to AI ADC exam. Let us move on to the question. Let us start with the basics. That is, what is a complex number? A number denoted as x plus iy, where x and y are real numbers and I is equal to root of minus 1 is called a complex number. A complex number can be denoted using any letter. Let us take z as a complex number which is given by x plus iy. Then the modulus of the complex number is denoted as mod z and it is equal to root of x square plus y square. This is called modulus of the complex number. And the conjugate of this complex number is denoted as z bar and it is equal to x minus iy. Now let us see some of the properties of a complex number. First property, two complex numbers x1 plus iy1 and x2 plus iy2 are equal if x1 is equal to x2 and y1 is equal to y2. That is real part. X1 and x2 are equal and imaginary part y1 and y2 are equal. Now we can see the second property. Second property is every complex number can be denoted as r into cos theta plus I sin theta. That is, our complex number x plus iy is equal to r cos theta plus I R sin theta. In the first property we have seen that two complex numbers are equal if the real part are equal and imaginary parts are equal. So we can equate the real parts and imaginary parts. X is equal to R cos theta and Y is equal to R sin theta. Let us denote it as equations 1 and 2. Squaring and adding equation 1 and 2. We will get x square plus y square is equal to r square cos square theta plus r square sin square theta. Taking r square as common, we will get cos square theta plus sin square theta. By Pythagorean identity, we know that this is equal to 1. So, we can write r square is equal to x square plus y square or r is equal to root of x square plus y square. This r is known as modulus of a complex number. And it is denoted by modulus of z. Or modulus of complex number is written as x plus iy. Now divide equation 2 divided by 1. We will get y by x is equal to r sin theta by r cos theta, or r and r get cancelled. Sin theta by cos theta is tan theta. From there we can write tan theta is equal to y by x, or theta is equal to tan inverse y by x. This is called amplitude or argument of a complex function and it is denoted as amplitude of a set or argument of a set. Since we are representing the complex number using the modulus and amplitude, this form of representation is called modulus amplitude representation. or it is also called polar representation. Let's do a problem from the section. Reduce 1 minus cos alpha plus I sin alpha to modulus amplitude 4. Given a complex number x plus iy is equal to 1 minus cos alpha plus I sin alpha. And we are asked to express this in modulus amplitude 4. That is r cos theta plus ir sin theta. We can write the real part as x is equal to 1 minus cos alpha and imaginary part is sin alpha. We know that modulus r is root of x square plus y square. That is root of 1 minus cos alpha the whole square plus sin square alpha. Expanding this we will get root of a minus b the whole square 4. So a square minus 2ab plus b square. 1 minus 2 cos alpha plus cos square alpha plus this sin square alpha. From Pythagorean identity, sin square alpha plus cos square alpha is equal to 1. Substituting, you will get root of 1 plus 1, 2 plus 2 minus, sorry, 2 minus 2 cos alpha. Taking 2 as common, 1 minus cos alpha. We know from trigonometry that cos 2 alpha is equal to cos square alpha minus sin square alpha or 2 cos square alpha minus 1 or 1 minus 2 sin square alpha. From here, again, taking this formula, we can write 2 sin square alpha is equal to 1 minus cos alpha. If the angle is halved, then the formula will be 2 sin square alpha by 2, 1 minus cos alpha. Here it is of this form, 1 minus cos alpha. So the angle is halved on either side. It is 2 sin square alpha by 2. 2 into 2 sin square alpha by 2. And we will get 2 sin alpha by 2 as the modulus. Now we have to find the angle theta, that is amplitude of the complex number. That is tan inverse y by x. Tan inverse y is given by sin alpha by 1 minus cos alpha. We know that sin 2 alpha is equal to 2 sin alpha cos alpha. Here also if the angle is halved, that is sin alpha is equal to 2 sin square alpha by 2 cos square alpha by 2. On substituting this, and 1 minus cos alpha is equal to 2 sin square alpha by 2. Substituting this and this in the given equation, we will get tan inverse. Instead of sin alpha, we are substituting 2 sin square alpha by 2 cos square alpha by 2 by 1 minus cos alpha is given by 2 sin square alpha by 2. Sorry, 2 sin alpha by 2 cos alpha. There is no square. Then we can cancel 2 and 2, 1 sin alpha and the square. Then we will get this is equal to tan, sorry, cot cos by sin. Cot alpha by 2. Theta is equal to cot alpha by 2. Theta is equal to tan inverse cot alpha by 2. Or taking tan inverse to this side, tan theta is equal to cot alpha by 2. We have obtained tan theta is equal to cot alpha by 2. We have to find theta. So let us express cot theta in tan's form. We know that tan 90 minus theta is cot theta. So it can be expressed as tan pi by 2 minus, here the angle is alpha by 2. Now we can equate. Now we go tan theta is equal to tan pi by 2 minus alpha by 2. So we can equate the angles. We obtain theta is equal to pi by 2 minus alpha by 2. Now we have obtained the modulus and angle, amplitude theta. So we can express this complex number in modulus amplitude, that is r cos theta plus ir sin theta. We can take r as common, r into cos theta plus I sin theta. Now we know the value of r and theta. R is 2 sin alpha. We can substitute for r and theta. R is equal to 2 sin alpha by 2 into cos theta is pi by 2 minus alpha by 2 plus I sin pi by 2 minus alpha by 2. This is the required modulus amplitude representation of the given complex number. Any complex number x plus I y can be represented as an ordered pair x, y. We know that we can express an ordered pair graphically on xy plane. This is an xy plane. This is the x axis, this is minus x axis, this is the y axis, and this is the negative y axis. This is the xy plane. When we are representing a complex number on an xy plane, this plane is known as complex plane or origin plane. Complex plane or origin plane. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, etc. 1, 2, 3. Minus 1, minus 2. Sorry. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. 1, 2, 3, etc. This is the origin 0 represented by the ordered pair 0, 0. Okay. Our complex number x plus iy can be represented as an ordered pair xy, and it will be any point on this plane according to the value of x and y. Let us take for example the complex number is 2 plus I3. So the ordered pair is 2, 3. We represent this ordered pair on the graph xy. Okay, the distance between this point xy and origin is given by modulus r, that is equal to root of x square plus y square. It is obtained from the distance formula. We know that according to distance formula, the distance is given by root of, let it be x1 y1, and this is x2 y2, and this is x1 y1. The distance formula gives the distance between two points, that is x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. Here x1 and x2 are 0 and 0, and x2 and y2 are x and y. So x minus 0 the whole square plus y minus 0 the whole square, and it is equal to root of x square plus y square. As an example, we have considered the point as 2, 2. Now we can see that case. Now we can consider this example 2 plus 3i represented as the ordered pair 2, 3. Then 2 is on the real axis and 3 is on the imaginary. So the x axis which denotes the real part is known as real axis of the complex plane, and the y coordinate that is denoted on the y axis is known as complex plane. It can denote 2, 3 on the scale as 2 on the real axis and 3 on the imaginary axis. And this is the point 2, 3. Distance from the origin 0, 0 is given by root of x square plus y square. Here x is 2 and y is 3. That is root of 2 square plus 3 square. That is root of 4 plus 9. Root 13. Okay. Now let us try to solve a previous year problem. The complex numbers z1 equal to 1 plus 2i, z2 is equal to 4 minus 2i, and z3 is equal to 1 minus xi form the vertices of A. Options are isosceles triangle, scalene triangle, right angle triangle and equilateral triangle. This is a question from the portion which we have discussed last. For this we have to plot these complex numbers on the complex plane. First of all, we can denote these complex numbers as ordered pair. First complex number is ordered pair 1, 2. Second complex number is the ordered pair 4 minus 2. And the third one is 1 minus 6. Now we can represent this on a complex plane and find how a triangle is formed. Whether it is an isosceles triangle, scalene triangle, right angle triangle or equilateral triangle. First of all, 1, 2, 1, 2. 1 on the real axis and 2 on the imaginary axis. This is the required point. 1, 2. Next point is 4 minus 2. 4 on the real axis and minus 2 on the imaginary axis. 4 minus 2. Next point, 1 minus 6. 1 minus 6. Now let us join all these points. We have to find whether this triangle is isosceles, scalene, equilateral or right angle triangle. For that we can find the sides, the measurement of the sides of the triangle. The sides, measurement of the sides can be found using, we have three points. So we can use the distance formula to find the sides. The length of this line is given by the distance formula. We know that distance formula is, if these are the two points x1, y1 and x2, y2 and this point is x3, y3. The distance, this distance is equal to root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. Where x1 is 1. Root of x2 is 4 minus x1 is 1. 4 minus 1 the whole square plus y2 is minus 2 minus y1 is 2 the whole square. That is root of 3 square plus 4 square, which is equal to 5. So the length of this line is 5. Similarly, root of x3 minus x2 the whole square plus y3 minus y2 the whole square gives the measurement of this line. That is root of 1 minus 4 the whole square, that is minus 3 square, that is 3 square plus minus 6 minus minus 2, that is minus 6 plus 2 minus 4 the whole square, which is also 5. Now the measurement of this line, root of 1 minus 1, 0 square plus minus 6, minus 2, minus 8, the whole square. This is equal to 8 square, which is 8. So the length of this line is 8. And we can see that two sides, measurement of two sides are equal. 5, 5, and the side's length is 8. So this is a triangle with two sides equal. We know that a triangle with two sides equal is known as isosceles triangle. So the required answer is isosceles triangle. Now we have covered all the important topics, that is the basics of complex number. If you have any doubt, you can send your comments under the video. And in the next video, we will learn about complex functions. Thank you.